after Cronus completes the simulation, you can get your results from the analysis menu. As you can see in the analysis menu, we have CYS parameters is active, the output manager is active. If you click on the output manager, then you can look at the time domain results, and if you look at the time domain results, you will find that there is voltage and the current at import 1. Because this problem is one port and it doesn't have more than one port, so we have import 1 only. If we have more than one port, if we have n port, then we will get voltage and the current at each port. So now we can hide the current and we can show the voltage, and if you plot here, then we will get the results of the voltage. So this is the voltage at the import, and as you can see that the voltage converges to zero, and at this time, and that means that the number of time steps that we used is enough. And if we have more oscillations, that means that we still need more time steps, but here we used 7000 time steps. And I can say that if we used only 3500 time steps, which may be at this location, that would be enough as well. Cronus can show us the results in the time domain and the frequency domain as well. So if we click on frequency domain results, then we can look at the voltage in the frequency domain. If you click on plot, then we have here the results in the frequency domain, and it shows us the results as magnitude and the phase. Now we can close the output manager, and we want to look now at the ZYS parameters. So this is here is the dialog box which shows us the results of the ZYS parameters, and if we click on matrix solution, we can see that we can plot many things here. We can look at the impedance matrix, admittance matrix, scattering matrix, port voltage, port current, port impedance, port voltage standing wave ratio, and all of these parameters we can look at them, and we can plot any parameter that we are interested on. Also, this is a rectangular plot, and we can use Smith chart. If you click on Smith chart, you can plot scattering matrix, for example, in the on the Smith chart. You have here scattering matrix and the port reflection coefficient. You can plot any one of them in the Smith chart. Let us return back to the rectangular plot, and we want to now plot the scattering matrix. And we have different options for the scattering matrix. You can plot the real and imaginary, or amplitude and phase, or amplitude in dB. Let us plot amplitude in dB, then click on plot. This is the S11 of this antenna, which shows us the ultra wide band behavior. As you can see, this antenna, it has S11 below minus 10 dB from this frequency, which is 3.39 gigahertz, up to this frequency, which is 13.2 gigahertz. So all of this here, as you can see, S11 is below minus 10 dB. So here we got the ultra wide band behavior for this antenna. Now we can close the ZYS matrix dialog box. Let us go now through another example. In the next example, we will show an example of simulating a reflector antenna.